I'm Liam. I've recently finished my master's project and I'm now working in the R&D team. I learned about the wildlife forensics project and it was something that I was interested in. It's part of a bigger project that's working with the Department of Conservation, which is around enforcing an international treaty called the CITES Treaty. The CITES Treaty is aimed at protecting the population levels of over 40,000 plant and animal species that are endangered or at risk of becoming endangered, and it basically just restricts international trade in those species. My project was looking at traditional medicine samples, which have the problem that you can't really tell what's in them just by looking at them. So we had a DNA-based method to try and identify what species were in them. I was really surprised by how sensitive the method was that I used. You could get results from really low input DNA amounts and even from some really quite highly processed samples, which was quite surprising in a good way. Surprising, I guess, in a not so good way on the flip side was the field of wildlife forensics. Although it's been around for kind of 20 plus years, some of the resources, mainly the reference databases of known species, are really not well looked after and not really fit for purpose for what they need to be. So that was one limiting factor that we ran into in terms of identifying what was in an unknown sample. You know, if it's not represented in the database, then it's kind of anyone's guess what's actually there. You can get samples sent from zoos and herbariums and things like that, but administrative work of sequencing them is a really slow process. And every lab kind of has to do it for themselves because there's no global wildlife forensics database that's good for what it needs to be. I like to stay involved because I'm really interested in the wildlife forensics space. Just trying to get a really broad coverage of a really wide range of different plant and animal species. Definitely for some of the species that Doc tends to see more of.